Hello dear students, let us discuss this exercise question. It's on page number 221. So the first question here is, a piece of wire of resistance R is cut into 5 equal parts. These parts are then connected in parallel. If the equivalent resistance of this combination is R dash, then the ratio R by R dash is dash. So that's the question. See, the question, we have a wire and the resistance of the wire is given to be R, which is cut into 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, which is cut into 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each part consists of resistance. As the whole resistance of the wire is R, each part consists of resistance R by 5, isn't it? So, that is Rs equal to R by 5 plus R by 5 plus R by 5 plus R by 5 plus R by 5, which gives us 5R by 5, which is equal to R. Hence, when the resistors are connected in series or as it is, it has the resistance R. Next one, parallel resistance RP. 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So, what is 1 by R1 here? 1 by R1 is individual resistance is R by 5. So, this becomes 1 by 1 divided by R by 5. What is 1 by 1 divided by? How we write 1 as 1 by 1? We can write 1 as 1 by 1 divided by R by 5. Now, how can we do this calculation? 1 by 1 into reciprocal of denominator. That is how we do the division of fractions. 5 by R. So, the answer is 5 by R. So, 1 by R1 is 5 by R plus again 1 by R2, same, 1 by R3, 1 by R4, 1 by R5. How this R1 becomes R by 5? Because we already got from here, individual resistance of a piece is R by 5. So, if they are connected in parallel, means 5 wires are connected in parallel, their resistance is given by 5 plus 5 plus 5, that is 25 by R, or RP is equal to R by 25, R by 25. Now, we have to do what? R by R dash. R by R dash means R by RP is equal to RS by RP is equal to RS is R, RP is equal to R by 25. Again, is the division of fraction. We can write R as R by 1 divided by, instead of divided by, we can multiply with the reciprocal, 25 by R. So, R get cancelled, the answer is 25. So, the answer here is 25. So, that is the answer of first question. See, second question. Which of the following terms do not represent electrical power in a circuit? We know the equation of powers, P equal to VI, that is the basic equation, P equal to VI. And we have another equation for V, or that is IR. Instead of V, we can write IR, IR into I, which gives us I square R. So, this is also equation of P, two equations we got. Now, in this equation, if we give value for I instead of V, what we get is, instead of I, we can give I equal to, we have the equation V equal to R I, or I equal to V by R. Take this R to the other side, V by R. So, instead of this I here, we can give V by R. So, it becomes V square by R. So, this is the third equation. See, in the here we can see I square R, VI and V square by R. So, the term that does not represent power is IR square. So, the answer is B, IR square. Okay, right? Moving to the third question. An electric bulb is rated 220 volt and 100 watt. See, is given potential difference and power is given. V equal to 220 volt, P equal to 100 watt. When it is operated on 110 volt, the power consumed will be dash. So we have to find the power consumed when it is operated on 100 volt. Sorry, 110 volt. So here power is given to us, and V2 is also given. What is that? 110 volt. P2 is not given to us. This we have to find. So we have P and V. We have the equation for power equal to V square by R. See, so 220 whole square divided by R gives us power. Here power is equal to 100 watt. So instead of power we can substitute the value 100 watt. So here 100 watt equal to 220 square by R. Take this R to the other side. So it becomes R equal to 220 whole square divided by 100, which is equal to 22 into 22, it is 22 square, 24, again 4, 44 again, or 484. So it gives us 484 and two zeros. If it is 220 into 220, it becomes here, it becomes two zeros. If we give two zeros here, so 484 double zero by 100 R. Cutting this, we get 484 ohm. So that's we got in the case of P1 V1. Here we got R1. So this resistance will not change. Resistance of a conductor does not change according to the voltage change. So this is constant for the next set also. So here resistance is already, we know, 484. It's 484. So see, now the resistance is given to us. So we can find the power using the same equation, P equal to V square by R. Here V is given. What is the new V? It's 110 volt, and resistance is 484, and we have to take the square, that is 110 all square, which is equal to 11 into 11 equal to 121 and double zero, 121 double zero by 484. See, this 121 and 484, we can cut each other. 121 into 4, 484, it's 484. So it's 4 times here, 1 times here. So it becomes 1000 by 4. Instead of this, we given 4. 100 by 4 is equal to 25. 25, we find the power. Therefore, it's 25 watt. So that's answer for third question. Now moving.